Hey yo, what is up? We are revisiting the E75DS in 2022 with equipment 2.0. Now this tank came out 2 years ago, and when I first got it, I really enjoyed playing this tank, but that was before equipment 2.0, and I played it, you know, mostly platoon almost all the time, and I enjoyed like an 80% win rate, insane win rate. I like this tank so much. But in 2022, things have changed. We've got equipment 2.0, we've got a lot of powerful tanks that are changing the landscape of the game, changing how we play this game. So this is like, you know, the renegade of the German nation. If you are familiar with the Renegade, we just reviewed that tank recently with equipment 2.0. I found it like to be quite a mobile heavy tank, and this tank is kind of similar in that sense. So I equipped it with turbo as well, vertical stabilizers and rammers. The speed definitely helped get this playing like a, more like a heavy medium tank. Just like a Renegade, but of course it is not a Renegade, but it does feel like, you know, very mobile. Like, you know, if you want to talk about the heavy tank space in tier 8s, it is completely crammed with so many choices of tanks. You've got the T56, you've got the Defenders, you've got the Renegades. There are so many tanks that are available to play with, you know, in tier 8 heavy tank space, and it is a very competitive, very crammed space. So if you want to be really good in this space, you need to be like, you know, kind of like a special tank, like a Renegade, hyper competitive tank, like a Škoda T56, very competitive tank in tier 8. And I feel like with the turbo in the E75TS, this tank, you know, it has just enough mobility and speed to get anywhere you want to and play as aggressive as you like. Now, we are in Erlenburg. This is a map that I have not played a lot of. In fact, if you watch me play for the first 3 minutes here, you can see me very pensive. You know, I am actually very scared to play this map. You can see me, you know, not really sure of myself, not really certain of the positions that I should be in or where should I go. I do have a rough idea that I should be around in the middle of the map, but I don't know if I have all the angles covered. I don't know if, you know, I'm just not very confident with this map. So that being said, I was not expecting a very good result, let's just say, in this map. I was just expecting to do okay. If I survive and do 2000 damage, 3000 damage, I would be, you know, more than happy. But it turned out to be something else. You know, as the game developed, you could see that the enemy team was not very aggressive, which, you know, as soon as you have a little bit of time on your hands, that's when a tank like this with good mobility and good armor comes into play, because you have time to think about what you want to do. You have time to plan your next move. You have time to look ahead. Your teammates are not, you know, being super aggressive and taking away all the damage that you could do for yourself, because, you know, in 2022, when you are playing random battles, these games go by very quickly most of the time. So it's very, it's not very often that you get a slow game, a medium-paced and a slow-paced game, where you have time to think about what you want to do, what positions you want to get into. Like right now, I know that I have that guy covered, and I could just hide behind here and possibly side scrape and farm a little bit of damage from these three tanks that are right in front of me, starting with this SU-101. I was not expecting to, you know, do a lot of damage in this game, but, you know, it's slowly, because the game is progressing so slowly, I've got the time to think about what I want to do, how I want to be aggressive or you know, move forward, trying to farm out as much damage as I can. The enemy team is not doing anything to threaten my position or you know, try to farm me in return. So what I can do is try to, you know, get the initiative, push forward, use my armor, take a little bit of damage, you know, trade damage to get some damage. And you know, with this tank you are getting a reload time of 10.83 seconds. You can get it lower than that if you're running BIA, if you're running food, if you have rammers. You know, 9 second reload, 9+ second reload is very good. And standard shell velocity is like 1100 meters per second, which is incredibly good for standard AP shells. But if you are running APCR shells, the shell velocity is even better, 1375 meters per second. Also, you get pretty good view range on this tank. Stock is 390, so this means you don't need to run any optics in order to get your view range close to 445 meters. So this frees up a slot for me. So instead of, you know, trying to max out my view range, I could just, you know, run that vertical stabilizer rammer, and then I have that extra slot in the first slot to run that turbo, which improves the mobility of this tank significantly. Now, there are some heavy tanks that even if you run a turbo, it does not make any difference at all, which is like the last tank that I made a video on. Wait, what was that video I made on the last tank? I slapped a turbo on it and it did not work out for me. But in a tank like the E75 TS and the Renegade, which is already kind of like a high mobility heavy tank, because the Renegade and the E75 TS got, you know, 45 kilometers an hour forward speed, and it's got a pretty good power to weight ratio. The Renegade's got 16.15 power to weight ratio, and the E75 TS has 16 power to weight ratio, which means when you slap a turbo on it, that power to weight ratio increases significantly, and it helps out that forward speed and reverse speed. So for mobile heavy tank like this, a turbo actually makes a lot of difference in you know, helping on the mobility and agility of this tank. Just like that, you know, in a game like this, when I was not expecting any kind of result on a map that I am not very confident in, was not expecting to do well at all, I've managed to eke out something like 3.5k damage at the moment. Also, I had some luck on my side, you could say, because my teammates were not hyper aggressive. The enemy was not hyper aggressive. They left a lot of time on the clock for me to progress, take my time, push forward, use my HP, use my armor, push forward, and farm out as much damage as I could. So I had a little bit of luck on my side. This kind of games do not happen all the time, especially in 2022, where a lot of the games, you know, the clock runs out in about 5-6 minutes and the game is over. But in this game it worked out for me, because everyone was pacing themselves out so slowly. It gave me a lot of time to think about what I want to do. Everything just fell into place for me, and I managed to get just over 4.4k damage and an ace tanker in this game. And I think I got a little bit of spotting damage as well, 1205 damage of assisted damage, which contributed to the ace tanker game. So there you go, E75TS in 2022 with a turbo is the way to go. Hope you enjoyed this video. I will see you on the next one. Bye bye.